This next group is going to make us feel things. And I cannot wait. Please put your hands together for three different Sabres!
So we're three different Sabres. All we need to get started is a life event. Like a type of life event.
New job.
A new job.
Great, okay.
I'm feeling good about this one.
Yeah?
Yeah. I think this is going to be the one.
You think so?
Yeah.
All right. Is this one of those ones from Monster again?
It was Monster, but then there was a second follow-up. You know how they got those headhunters that just kind of do their thing?
Yeah.
Right? You know, they keep contacting me, and I'm like, no, that's not the right one. But then I saw this one on Monster.
Yeah.
And then the next day, I get the call. Yeah. And I'm like, it's the same thing, so it's got to work this time, right?
Right. And it's not?
What?
It's not working? Like, or it didn't work?
Well, no, I think it's going to work. I think this is the one.
Well, right, yeah, this time. But, I mean, like, what did you do different?
I mean, it was two contacts.
But did you do anything different?
I mean, I don't think I did anything different.
Think back. Think about the first contact. What did you respond with? Because, you know, you're not going to get the same result if you're not doing something different. You know, if you get a different result, you must have did something different.
I mean, I started using hashtags on my resume.
There you go. This place likes hashtags.
Yeah.
They're trendy. What's this place called? What's the name of this place?
It's some new startup.
Oh, they're all new startups.
Yeah, I know. Mm-hmm. But, you know, they just kind of use mostly buzzwords. So I'm not quite sure what I'm doing.
Is it BuzzFeed?
Oh no, it's not.
Oh no. I was like, they're established.
I walked away from BuzzFeed.
That's what I was saying. I mean, that was okay. So this is like a new trendy.
Chris?
Yeah.
Chris, why would you bring up BuzzFeed?
You said buzzwords.
Yeah.
I was checking in. Look, I only see every 4 months, okay? Sorry. I forgot that you were sensitive. Get your hair cut more. I don't want to do it like this.
Maybe if you just invite me over for one of your client, you know, barbecues.
It's because I don't invite you to the barbecue?
Do I not come enough to...
You don't eat meat. It's difficult to have you.
What do you mean it's difficult to have me? I'm doing less than the people that are already there.
Yeah, but then I have to buy special things for you. I have to buy special veggie burgers, and no one eats them, and then I have a box of veggie burgers in my house with only 1 to 2 veggie burgers missing.
Maybe you could try a veggie burger once in a while, Chris.
Tell me more about this job.
I'm just kind of hopeful. I've been, you know, out of it for a while. I tried marketing. Mm-hmm. I tried sales. I tried a little bit of everything. It looks like this place is just kind of looking for a little bit of everything.
All right. So good. When's the interview?
About 3 hours.
From now?
Yeah. What?
Is this how you're going? Is this what
Well, I'm hoping you're going to be done.
You got time to go home and everything?
Yeah, I got time to go home.
I'm getting hair everywhere. You're going to be itchy. You have time for a shower?
I'm not wearing a suit. Do you think, like, if I got my hair cut in a suit, then I'd understand the concern?
You have a suit?
Yeah. Mostly. I've got 2 parts of 2 suits.
Which parts? Did BuzzFeed not make you dress up? I'm sorry, not supposed to say BuzzFeed. If this is a place that, you know, they might also not make you dress up. Did you find out about the dress code there, the place? Because if you come in a suit and it's not a suit place, you're actually going to look ridiculous.
Well, I mean...
I wouldn't come in this, but, you know, I would...
I'm going to kind of have everything prepared in the car. I'm going to get, like, a look in the windows before I come in, and then,
you're
going to
look in the windows?
Yeah.
I'm
I'm gonna have my pants on. I got my binoculars.
Well, yeah, keep your pants on.
Yeah, I'm gonna keep my pants on.
You don't want to take your pants off and look in the windows. Yeah. I really frown upon that.
I'm gonna look in the windows. I'm gonna see like maybe one of my two vests could work.
Yeah.
And then see maybe that sport coat's gonna work out. And hey, who knows? Maybe none of them are needed.
You got this all packed in your car?
Yeah. It's under all my other clothes.
You got a printed copy of your resume?
I took a picture of it with my phone.
Alright. Probably fine for a trendy place. What'd you have for breakfast this morning? What would you do in a conflict?
Which one do you want me to answer first?
I'm rapid firing it. That's what's gonna happen in the interview. You're gonna look alive. How's your LinkedIn profile?
Hold on, I'm still thinking about breakfast.
I
mean, I had a few things, but I stayed up pretty late. So was I up late enough for that to be considered breakfast? Because I didn't get a lot of sleep.
What kind of monster considers a late night snack breakfast?
The late night snack was 5 a.m. because I couldn't sleep.
That's breakfast.
But then I went to sleep for a little bit.
How long?
Like an hour and a half.
Oh. Did you eat again after that?
I had a hard-boiled egg.
That could be brunch.
And I had finger sandwiches at 11:30.
That also could be brunch.
I know.
God, you live a hard life. Just take care of yourself more. This is good, though. This is something. This is technically self-care.
What?
Getting a haircut.
I don't know. I kind of feel stressed out.
What?
What?
Why? Because I'm near the ears part?
No. You're making me nervous.
By the interview?
You're saying my suit's not enough? There's some sort of crisis befalling me in the future?
No, this is good. I'm stressing you out now, so in the interview, you won't even, it'll be half the stress in the interview, and it'll be like, this was a breeze, and it'll fool you, you know, because if I get you amped up now, then you'll suddenly think that, you know, by the time you get to the interview, it's like, well, that's all right. You know what I'm saying? You know?
Yeah.
It's like if you get used to listening to like fireworks, and then you go to like a concert, you're used to listening to a concert, then you know maybe like an inside an airplane doesn't sound so loud.
I mean, that's not really a good thing. That's more hearing damage than success.
Yeah. All right. Sure. Yeah, that's fine. It's coming out pretty good.
Hey, Chris, you got to be honest with me for a second.
Yeah.
I mean, you see worse sad sex than me, right?
Yo, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Especially around here.
Oh.
Yeah. When I was over on the east side, it wasn't so bad, but around here, yeah, it's real bad. Real, real sad people. Yeah. I had this one guy, he's got hemorrhoids like you wouldn't believe. He can't even sit. Every couple minutes, he's got to get up. Yeah.
It's got to be tough.
That's tough, yeah. Got this other guy, his kids won't talk to him. And he shaved his mustache. Now they still won't talk to him. I thought it was the mustache.
Yeah.
It obviously wasn't the mustache.
Chris, I got a quick question for you.
Yeah.
How many burgers did they eat?
Yeah, well, let's go. Not a barbecue?
I'm just wondering who does and who doesn't get it. Is it just the veggie burger thing?
You're not fun. Is that what you want to hear?
I don't want to hear that.
Well, just being...
I mean, what I wanted to hear was, yes, come to my next barbecue. It's Sunday the 29th.
How do you know when my next barbecue is?
Because we talk!
You don't, like, interact with people. No.
Wait for them to interact with me.
Yeah, but then everyone's thinking, who's with the quiet? What's with the quiet guy? You know? Yeah,
look at that quiet guy over there. I bet he has great stories. He's lived a long and varied life, and I'm sure that he'd love to tell me about it. And I'm going to go and I'm going to introduce myself and show him this veggie burger that I brought with me.
Has that ever worked out for you?
It's been a while.
I'm just saying, you know, like, listen, I know you're a good guy, right? You and I go way back. I've been cutting your hair since you were I don't know, 15?
Yeah.
I know that you've got a lot of potential, you know, and that you're very hireable and, you know, can be personable. It's just, but I can't, you know, I can't hold your hand the whole time at my party because, you know, every time, everybody wants time with me, you know. They're there to see me.
Yeah.
So then I worry about you, and if I'm stopping to worry about you because I'm thinking, well, he's not having a good time because he's just waiting for people to come up to him and be like, hey man, tell me a story. Which is not what happens.
I got some great stories.
Well, people like to talk about themselves.
Yeah.
So you ask people questions. Life's about asking questions. You ask questions and people like you. That's all you gotta do. You just act interested. Ask anybody a question, they suddenly love you. It doesn't take too much. How you doing? Oh, how'd that go? Wow, oof. Done. It'll work every time. Wanna try it? How you doing? Ugh. That's rough.
No, I mean, I was just thinking about that car race that I went to the other day. It was really cool.
Mm-hmm.
It was like really loud.
Yeah.
There was an old lady, she was protesting it, but like she was like across a field. And she just had a sign up that said, stop.
Yeah.
Didn't work. You like that story?
No.
I got more.
Whole lot of you. Not a great storyteller. Nothing happens in your stories. There's no danger, you know?
I mean, there was cars that were racing. There's lots of danger.
You ever get that DNA swab? I'd be genuinely curious with you.
I swabbed, but I didn't send it in.
You didn't send it in?
No.
Oh, Jesus. Send it in before the interview. It's gonna come up. It's a hot topic. Someone's gonna say, have you done it yet? And if you said, yeah, I swabbed and didn't send it in, come on. I wouldn't hire someone who wouldn't send in a DNA swab. If you can't get back to the mailbox, what are you going to get to the mailbox?
I'm not going to have the info in time for the interview.
Does it? You don't need the info. You're just going to say, I just mailed it in. I'm waiting for the results.
I'm just kind of waiting. I'm the waiting guy.
You're the waiting guy. That's why you got to be the asking guy. Try being the asking guy. Why'd you start with this company? What do you love about the company? Where's the cafeteria? I love it.
Yeah.
Are those windows I saw coming in? Those are great. Doesn't matter what it is.
Man, I wish I had more practice. You know, social situation,
mm-hmm.
Random people I don't know.
Try giving haircuts.
Getting to know them. I don't know if I have the dexterity for haircuts, but I do get hungry occasionally. My Sundays are free.
Are you sitting straight? Is this too straight?
I don't know. Am I too much of a sad sack to sit straight for you? I felt that. I can hear from those scissor snips that there's some anger behind you. I know you took down the mirror on this chair for me.
I did. I'm real close to your neck now.
I'm just saying, maybe it doesn't even have to be a barbecue. You know, maybe it's a fun time client lunch.
What?
43 minutes.
Could you bring a dish or something if you come?
Got a bag of chips in my car?
No. A dish. A dish. I want a reason to return a plate to you. You know what I'm saying? Give me a dish.
What if it was a can of Pringles? You can store stuff in there. Tennis balls.
What do you do? What do you do for fun? What do you do when you have fun? Think about the last time you smiled.
I was looking at an old high school yearbook.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. It was good times.
That's... That's it?
What?
Alright.
I almost joined a club in high school.
You almost joined a club?
Yeah.
What stopped you?
There's a lot of choices on club day. I was just kind of waiting for one of the captains of the clubs to come over to me and be like, hey, I want you.
You got some stories?
I didn't really have a lot of stories back then.
Yeah,
but
no,
I was ready to make stories.
You can't just wait for life to happen. You have to go in there, you know? You have to just try things and do things and make decisions and be wrong and... You just sit around and wait for someone to come to you. You're just gonna rot there.
Yeah. Hey, Chris.
Yeah.
Why'd you start doing those barbecues anyways?
Well, some of my clients had good drugs and I wanted to invite them over.
Oh. It was a
different time back then.
And you just kept it going?
Yeah, 25 years now. You know, then it was all about the party, now it's more about the family time, and, you know, everybody's got grandkids now, and kids growing up, you know, it's nice, it's a nice time, and then, you know, sometimes there's this, 30-ish something sad sack standing there next to the veggie burgers. Look at you.
I don't know if you noticed what I did there, Chris.
I'm gonna bring down the size a little bit, don't worry. What did you do?
I asked you a question, I got you to talk.
Yeah, you see? And I opened up to you a little bit.
Yeah.
And I liked you a little bit more for a second.
Mm-hmm.
You notice how I integrated you in that story? Because at least you're the sad sack that's there.
I don't want to be the sad sack that's not invited anymore. I don't want to be the sad sack that doesn't have a job.
Stage picture. Yeah, keep going.
So you got all the mirrors over there.
Yeah, well, other people deserve mirrors. Other people, I care about what they think of their haircut while I'm giving it to them. You, I don't care for you to see it before it's done. Because you're better off interacting with a finished product than you are with a process. When you interact with a process...
What's that supposed to mean?
Well, because you get all persnickety about
what
processes.
What are you talking about?
What are you talking about? Are you serious?
No,
sometimes you just like, you're like, well, this process. And so sometimes I just got to show you the finished product. And you're like, oh, that's good. Fix this. And I'm like, great. But if you saw what it looked like halfway through, you would have been very upset. You know, because sometimes I like to start in the back. It makes you look like an idiot for a little while. And I like it. I picture you looking like that all the time. It makes me laugh. And then I fix it. You could be in a flock of seagulls. You looking in the mirror? Hey,
yeah,
hey, hey!
What?
Oh, I really missed some spots back here.
I don't think I'm going to do well in this interview.
No, I don't think so either. But you know what? You could do better than you thought. And that's pretty good.
What?
Well, if you don't think you're going to do well,
yeah.
One of the possible outcomes is that you did better than you thought at the end. And that's not so bad.
Okay. So we're talking like setting the bar low.
Yeah. Works for a lot of people, to be honest with you. A lot of people sort of go in thinking, well, I'm not going to do too good of a job.
Yeah.
Yeah. And if they deliver anything at all, you know, people are all excited. Or at least what it feels like, you know.
Yeah.
really just really messed this part up. I'm fixing it though, don't worry. I'll fix it. You know, I was never trained in this. Actually, I have a sculpture minor.
I know.
And that's what makes me feel qualified.
Yeah.
But, you know, hey.
Yeah, I mean,
I do tell all my clients that, so, in all fairness.
Yeah.
You know, no one's walking in blind.
Plus that fake diploma you have on the wall.
Yeah, that's certainly not real.
Yeah.
But, you know, hey.
I don't know, you shouldn't put it in a place that isn't a mirror, because then people are going to look at it in detail.
Not when this mirror's around. That's all distracted. Plus, you've got curly hair. It's very forgiving. God, it's so thick back here.
So, the main reason I want to go to your barbecues. I mean, you're going to laugh at me.
I have.
And you're probably going to sarcastically make fun of me.
Mm-hmm.
But we see each other once every 4 months, and you're probably my closest friend.
When you come to the barbecue, don't worry about the dish.
Yeah?
Yeah. Just bring those chips up, all right? Are they weird chips? Is there something weird about them? Are they like flax or something weird? No, they just want regular chips there.
Well, I mean, they're like dried beet and parsnip and carrot chips. it's that new brand Terra,
Yeah, no, I know that. Yeah, don't just
the bags you can't really open.
Yeah.
But they got that little hole punched in them to help you out with that opening.
Yeah, does it help?
I mean, it does once you find it.
Mm-hmm.
They didn't print an open here on it, so you gotta kind of look close and try to find it.
Yeah, bring those.
Yeah. I was really hoping by sometime you'd at least say the word friendship back.
I want to lie to you.
Oh, that's the end of that sentence.
You know, I've known you for a long time.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, I would like to keep cutting your hair because it's very thick. And I charge by the hour. But you know, you're a client.
All right.
And you're gonna make some friends. Come to the barbecue. Come to the client's barbecue, where the other clients are, who I also don't call my friends, in all fairness.
Okay.
All right? Only Denise is actually my friend, but her and I are different. The rest of you are not my friends. The rest of you are my clients that I have over for my client barbecue.
I mean, there's got to be someone you got in mind for me, then.
Someone in mind for
yes.
you?
Yes.
You want me to yen to you in addition to having you invited over?
You're the one who has all the answers, who knows everything.
All right. Wear a bright color. All right, something that makes you stand out a little bit.
Okay.
Well, so this way I can approach some people and be like, hey, look at the guy in the purple, huh? And if they're like, I'm like, okay, moving on. You know, and they're like, huh? And I'll say, hey, why don't you come meet my friend? That's our show.
How's it look?
Keep it good, just be here and save
it. Oh my God.
Wow. Wow, it's like someone blew up a Wolverine on this stage. Oh my God.